Magic Carpet slash PLM is a set of new control laws and display symbology specifically for the F-18 that drastically reduces the workload necessary to safely and accurately land an F-18.
It's a game changer in that it reduces the amount of workload that the pilot has to get aboard the boat. So they can observe and react to corrections sooner in these modes than they could in the legacy control modes.
Center ball and hands off. There's a burble, hands off. Hands off. Slight left, hands off.
Flew a lot without it, and all the things that we talk about landing on the ship, it's very difficult and you have to practice a lot. And with Magic Carpet, it is way simpler, way safer. The performance was much better, and I wish I could attribute it to myself, but it is not. It was the flight control laws there helped me a lot.
So we're in the second phase of a two-phase program. The first phase was really a demonstration program, getting from the simulator for the leadership to say, hey, this looks really great in the sim, but is it really going to transform into what we see in flight? And that was phase one, which we went out to the USS Bush in 2015, demonstrated that, hey, what we saw in the sim was almost identical to what we see at the ship. Senior leadership saw that. They saw the capability we were demonstrating with some very off-nominal corrections out there and the performance the system had. It really energized the naval leadership to say, hey, we want this sooner rather than later.
And so we started literally from the summer of 15 with the entire goal and mindset to get this out in approximately a year. Previous schedule was about 2 years, so it was about a 50% reduction in our schedule.
And that is what we have, what we've delivered now so far is a version for the fleet to use, because we're giving them the opportunity to use the system, use it in a fleet setting, in an operational setting, on deployment, doing combat ops.
The benefits there are that they start giving us feedback for the phase two effort, where we have two additional software builds to integrate and enhancements, get that in so that the final capability that we deliver in 2019 has had a lot of exposure, not only out of our carrier suit testing here, but also, more importantly, in fleet deployment for what they have to do.
Coming down nicely. There's a ball.
The feedback we've gotten is overwhelmingly positive at this point. So some very, very challenging conditions on both the Atlantic and Pacific, where they've had the opportunity to use Magic Carpet, and it has increased performance and boarding rate and all that stuff. By, you know, we're tracking those numbers, and it is startling how much better it is.
I think Magic Carpet is a prime example of what can happen when you have a small, empowered team. I can't stress that enough. It was a core group of individuals that were smart, was the right people on the small, empowered team, and we did something I think that was pretty rare in DoD acquisitions, and it has been amazingly successful and well-received by the operators.
Release, right there.
When we're energized by leadership to set some goals on short-term, speed to the fleet and capability. There's resources here within NAVAIR and our partners within the contractor that we can make those commitments and deliver. So all in all, it's, you know, rewarding to see a transformation from paper to ONR seeding this, to leadership seeing it and providing the funding, to demonstrating it on the ship. And in just a handful of years has been rewarding both on the engineering side as well as our air crew.